Hey, I'm RJ Byrne, University of Georgia, Thomas County Ag Agent, and today I got with me Dr. Prosco, and we're at a conference right now, and Dr. Prosco is going to talk about your herbicide programs you need to be thinking about in 2011. Dr. Prosco?
Hey, RJ, this is Dr. Eric Prosco with the University of Georgia. I'm an extension weed specialist that covers several crops, including peanuts, corn, soybeans, sunflowers, grain sorghum, canola. But today I'm just going to spend a few minutes talking to you about weed management options for peanuts, and we may come back and visit on some other crops later. But of course, we continue to have significant pigweed problems, and that's the number one question at this point that everyone wants to ask. So a couple of things to think about as we're going into the next season is to a couple of thoughts that I have. First is that to continue to think about using a yellow herbicide such as prowazonolin as a foundation for our weed control programs. And then as we get into the heavy pigweed situations, we certainly want to think we've got at least two options to consider. One would be the use of Valor in a pre-emergence program. Valor's probably being used on 60-70% of our peanut acres at this point. It's shown to be very effective for palm or amaranth control. It's doing an outstanding job. Also does very well on other weeds, such as Florida beggarweed. We're spending a lot of time on pigweed these days, but we do have other weeds like Florida beggarweed, tropical spiderwort, and other things. The other herbicide program we're going to potentially rely on for pigweed management would be a dual magnum based program. The nice thing about the dual program is that we can use it in various ways. We can put it out pre-plant incorporated, we can put it out pre-emergence, we can put it out post-emergence for residual control of palm or amaranth, and in Thomas County, more importantly, as well, would be tropical spiderwort. One thing we want to remember about dual, though, how we're putting it out, it does not provide post-emergence control of weeds, it only provides residual control. So if you're going to use it in peanuts for managing pigweed, you're going to tank mix it with Gramoxone or possibly Cadre if you're still using Cadre, or maybe even Cobra. Get a lot of questions about the usefulness of Cadre on pigweed, and we also have resistance to that particular class of chemistry, but if you don't, Cadre is still an outstanding herbicide for the control of palm or amaranth, but if you do believe you have resistance to that, there's other things you could use like Blazer or Cobra, but they have to be, those applications have to be very timely. We need to control weeds with the post-emergence herbicide, generally when they're less than 4 inches tall, preferably 2 to 3 inches would be optimum size. So we do have a lot of options. One other thing we're seeing a lot more of across the state is that we're using non-selective applicators later in the season to help manage those populations that may have gotten by or other control strategies. We recently got a label for Gramoxone and Intion and some of those applicators. If you come to the winter meetings this year, we'll be talking a little bit more about that. Certainly don't want to use that as a main control strategy. That's more of a salvage treatment, or Custer's last stand, as I like to call it, in our war against palm or amaranth. So I think in peanuts we do have a lot of good options. Certainly if you've got irrigation, that's going to give you the potential to be more successful. If you're a dry land grower, we have a few more challenges because we need moisture to activate those herbicides.
So what about the use of these weed wipers and these roller drums? What do you think about those, Dr. Prosco?
Well, I think they have a place in our production systems. I don't think we need to rely on those. That can't be our main focus of our attack on pigweed. That has to be something we use. After all other options have failed, we have that to fall back on. They are showing themselves to be very effective. And I think the most important thing we could benefit from those applicators is, particularly on those weeds that have escaped control, we may be able to prevent seed production for next year. If we cut down on the number of seed that are produced this year, it should have an effect in subsequent years.
Right. Thanks, Dr. Prosco.